If the last time you've heard text-to-speech was something like,
"Hello, how are you?"
then you're in for a surprise. Move over, Google Translate, there is a new king in town. ElevenLabs AI is an innovative voice generation tool, and I'll tell you in advance, it is scary how close it gets to a real human voice. Don't believe me? Well, there will be three passages in this video that were voiced with ElevenLabs, imitating
my voice.
Can you guess which ones those are? I'll wait for your answers in the comment section below. Oh, and don't forget to subscribe while you're there. Natural sounding speech is the main gimmick of ElevenLabs voice generation and what sets it apart from the competition. ElevenLabs AI model analyzes text or speech inputs and synthesizes it into a voiceover spoken with a different voice and style. I find it really impressive that this AI is not just focused on English. There are a dozen available languages and some voice options are specifically tailored to a specific language. This kind of voiceover can easily be used to create audiobooks.
Chapter 1. It was well known that the universe, as well as life,
podcasts,
and here we are again, talking about geopolitics, all as you like,
be used in movies or game productions, be utilized as an accessibility tool for mute people, or even completely drive me out of a job. But it's not like this AI voice generator is completely impossible to tell from a real human, especially since ElevenLabs has a feature called AI Speech Classifier, which can analyze any voice and tell you if it's an AI voice made by ElevenLabs. Just don't use it to cheat and find the AI generated parts of this video. That wasn't part of the deal, my friends. You might be asking, have I used ElevenLabs voice before? And to that, I have to answer, well, no. Why would I do that?
Of course I haven't. Please don't slander me.
Ooh, wait a second. Yeah. Johnny. Meet Jeremy, the AI voice behind my YouTube shorts. Jeremy is the American-Irish excited narrator, according to ElevenLabs at least, and you can hear that he sounds quite convincing. So let's quickly go through the pros of ElevenLabs. First, as you have heard for yourself, it generates a very natural voiceover. If you're not sure it's that lifelike, try and find the two whole paragraphs I've generated for this video already. Second, the ElevenLabs voice AI generation is extremely fast. It takes only a few minutes to make multiple paragraphs of AI generated voiceover. Thirdly, if you take a listen, which you already had, the audio is all very high quality. This makes it suitable for a variety of media without worrying that it won't be up to standard. Even if you're just looking for something for your personal project, you will get a high definition audio file. Fourth, and perhaps the most important upside, is the voice cloning, which is just phenomenal. For the fake voice I used in parts of this video, I used the cloning feature, and it sounds very convincing. The best part is that all it took was feeding the generator about 5 or 6 samples of my voice. On the other hand, I totally get that this feature is very abusable, so do not go out impersonating real people. It is not cool. Needless to say, no matter how awesome it is, there are downsides to ElevenLabs. For instance, it has some trouble dealing with punctuation and pauses, making unnatural pauses between words or no pauses at all, so I always have to be mindful of my comma usage. There's also no option to cut your audio directly in ElevenLabs, so you'll have to use external software. One more downside is also related to punctuation. It's absolutely necessary to punctuate your questions and exclamations, otherwise you end up with some weird sounding audio. The same can be said if you overuse these symbols. In terms of symbols, there are strict limits, 5,000 per generation and a variable monthly limit depending on the plan. This is yet another downside, since if you have a long text to voice act, it might take multiple generations to cover. Though personally, I find it's not that big of a deal, since you'll end up going back to fix things from time to time anyway. And it's easier to fix small passages rather than a whole lot of text. Now that you know what to expect from this AI tool, let me show you how to use ElevenLabs. First of all, ElevenLabs pricing. While it has a free plan, it's rather lackluster with 10,000 characters a month. You are not going to be generating a whole lot with that, and you won't be able to use it for commercial purposes anyway. Not until you get the starter plan. This plan's only $1 for the first month, but it has a bigger character cap, allows up to 10 custom voices and access to cloning. I've used it 3 times in this video, by the way, so let me know in the comments if you have spotted it. So if you're going for the free plan, just click this yellow button on the main page and log in. After that, you can generate whatever you want within the free plan limit. If you went for the starter plan, there are more options available for you. You can choose between AI voice, text to speech, and speech to speech generation. Choose a preferred AI voice actor and fine tune the voice you've chosen. You can easily get ElevenLabs best voice settings as long as you play with stability and similarity a little bit. Stability determines how random each new iteration would be. So if you're generating a big text in pieces, it's better to keep it high. But for multiple different videos, it's fine to lower it a bit and get more randomized, expressive outputs. That said, put it down too much and you can end up with a very goofy voiceover.
YouTube is an American online video sharing and social media platform owned by Google.
Similarity and clarity are used to set up how much to the original voice your output should be. Keep in mind, if it's too high and the original audio is poor quality, you can get background noises as part of your new AI voice. After you're done with fine-tuning, there are multiple AI models to choose from, depending on your needs. In my experience, there are subtle differences between these platforms, so you'll have to test them out and see which one sounds the best with your preferred AI actor. Personally, I default to Multilingual V1. It's been doing a great job of my YouTube shorts. From there, go ahead and type your text. At the bottom of the text window, you'll see how many symbols you can type and how many words you've used this month. Once you've pressed the generation button, the AI voice generator will produce your result and you can freely download or share it afterwards. If you want to add your own voice or anyone else's voice, press this add voice button and the add generative or cloned voice. Here you can either design a voice with an AI preset or clone someone's voice as I did. In that case, you'll need to upload samples and then choose a newly added voice before generation. Once again, remember not to abuse ElevenLabs AI. Yeah, alright, funny YouTube videos of the US president saying dumb stuff is fine, but trying to trick people is just a big no-no. To summarize, ElevenLabs is a generative AI voiceover tool. It generates very realistic voiceovers, either based on fully artificial voices or cloning a voice of a real person. All voiceover is provided as high-definition audio files, and it's possible to use it completely free. Remember, there are still parts of this video that were voiced by ElevenLabs clone of my voice, so go ahead and try and discover them all. Don't forget, if you didn't find them all, you have to like this video and subscribe. That was the deal. I appreciate you watching until the very end, and I hope to see you soon. Bye-bye for now.